In this segment, we're going to talk about some background about improper integrals. So before we talk about what numerical methods to use to do improper integration, let's talk about what an improper integral means. So if you look at a typical integral, it's given in the form a to b f of x dx, a definite integral. And what improper integral is that there can be several cases where you will consider a particular integral to be improper. One is where A or and B are infinite. That means they can be A can be plus infinity, A can be minus infinity, B can be minus infinity, and B can be plus infinity. So any of these combinations, or you don't necessarily have to have each A as A also having an infinite limit and B also having an infinite limit, one of them can be. So if A or and B are infinite, then it's considered to be an improper integral. Of course, we're only talking about integrals in which where the integral is valid in terms of that it's not unbounded. And the second one is where the integrand is singular. So you may have an integrand where, like integrand meaning f of x, is singular at some point, either at the endpoints or at an endpoint or somewhere between the two limits of integration. So the best thing to do is to look at some examples. That might be the best thing to do. So the ones where your lower or upper limit are infinite, you could have something like 1 to infinity e to the power minus x squared dx, let's suppose. That's an improper integral. You could have minus infinity to minus 2 e to the power minus x squared dx, for example. That's also an improper integral. You could have 1 divided by square root of x minus 1 dx going from 1 to, let's suppose, 10. That's an improper integral based on the fact that the integrand here at x equal to 1, which is the lower limit, it is becoming, the denominator is becoming 0, so 1 divided by 0 is infinite. You could also, let's suppose somebody gives you something like this, is 1 divided by 10, 1 divided by x minus 1 dx. Now, this is an improper integral also, but it's not defined, because what's going to happen is that when you do this integration, that will not turn out to be a bounded number or a finite number. So we are only talking about improper integrals for which the integral does exist, because that's the one where you can find the value numerically, hopefully. You can also have integrals like this. You can have f of x dx going from minus 5 to plus 5, where f of x is equal to 1 divided by square root of x for x greater than 0, and it's equal to 1 divided by square root of minus x for x less than 0. So you could have integrals where the infinite nature or x less than equal to 0 or greater than equal to 0. So where the integrand becomes infinite, not necessarily at the endpoints, but somewhere in the at some point between the lower limit and the upper limit of integration. Sometimes people think that in order for a integral to be improper, that only at endpoints it can have infinite values or singular values. But that's not necessarily true, as you can see for this particular integral. So these are the kind of examples which are existing for improper integrals. In the next segment, we'll talk about how we can integrate such improper integrals. And that is the end of this segment.